हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू द फोर्थ लेसन और फोर्थ पार्ट ऑफ चैप्टर 8, दैट इज इंट्रोडक्शन टू ट्रिग्नोमेट्री। सो चिल्ड्रन, अप टिल नाउ वी हैव सीन व्हाट आर 6 ट्रिग्नोमेट्रिक रेशियोज, देन द ट्रिग्नोमेट्रिक वैल्यूज ऑफ सम स्पेसिफिक एंगल्स लाइक 0 डिग्री, 30 डिग्री, 45 डिग्री, 60 डिग्री, 90 डिग्री, then trigonometric ratios of complementary angles and trigonometric identities. So let us revise once again what are trigonometric identities. So here the first one is cos square theta plus sin square theta is equal to 1. Children, from this one identity you can derive two more. How? If I shift this sin square theta on right hand side, so you will get cos square theta is equal to 1 minus sin square theta, right? Now the second identity, if I shift cos square theta on the other side, then you will get sin square theta is equal to 1 minus cos square theta. Same way, second identity, if I shift this tan square theta on the right hand side, so you will get sec square theta minus tan square theta is equal to 1, right? And if I shift 1 on right hand side, so you will get tan square theta is equal to sec square theta minus 1. Same way, third identity, if I shift this cot square theta on right hand side, so you will get cosec square theta minus cot square theta is equal to 1. And if I shift 1 on the right hand side, then you will get cot square theta is equal to cosec square theta minus 1. Now, using these identities, let us solve examples. So this is MCQ type questions. Though it is MCQ, but the answers are not obvious. You need to simplify it and then identify the correct answer. So the first is 9 sec square A minus 9 tan square A. Right? And the four options are given. So let us write down the given question once again. And children, we have identity that sec square A is equal to 1 plus tan square A. So here from the question, you replace this sec square A by 1 plus tan square A. So in second step, you will get 9 into sec square A is replaced by 1 plus tan square A minus 9 tan square A. Now you multiply this 9 inside the bracket. So 9 into 1 is 9 plus 9 into tan square A minus 9 tan square A. So plus 9 tan square A minus 9 tan square A will get cancelled and you will remain with 9 plus 0. So the answer is 9. So the correct option is option B. Understood? Now next, choose the correct option again. So the given question is 1 plus tan theta plus sec theta, second bracket, 1 plus cot theta minus cosec theta. So children, what we will do, we will convert this tan, sec, cot and cosec in terms of sine and cos. We have discussed what is the relation between this tan, sec, cot, cosec in terms of sine, cos. So you write down the first step, you see this step, 1 plus this tan theta can be written as sine theta upon cos theta, plus sec theta can be written as 1 upon cos theta, bracket close. Now come to the second bracket, 1 plus this cot theta can be written as cos theta upon sin theta minus this cosec theta can be written as 1 upon sine theta. Done. Now in next step, what you do? You take the LCM. So now LCM of first bracket is cos theta. Now accordingly you balance the numerator. So in the numerator you will get cos theta plus sin theta plus 1 into LCM in the second bracket is sin theta. Now you rearrange the term or balance the numerator, you will get sin theta plus cos theta minus 1. Now in next step, here what we will do, you take cos theta plus sin theta in one bracket and plus 1 outside, and in the second again sin theta plus cos theta in one bracket minus 1 outside the bracket, right? So this will transform into a plus b a minus b form, right? And cos theta plus sin theta plus 1, sin theta plus cos theta minus 1. So this is in the form of a minus b a plus b. So using this identity, this will become a square. A is what? Cos theta plus sin theta the whole square minus 1 square, and divided by cos theta into sin theta. Now that cos theta plus sin theta the whole square, that you can expand by using a plus b the whole square formula. So you will get cos square theta plus sin square theta plus 2 cos theta sin theta minus 1 square is 1, divided by cos theta into sin theta. Now children, you take this cos square theta plus sin square theta in one bracket. So since cos square theta plus sin square theta is equal to 1, this is equal to 1 plus 2 cos theta sin theta minus 1. So this plus 1 and minus 1 will get cancelled. So 2 cos theta sin theta upon cos theta sin theta. So this cos theta sin theta upon cos theta sin theta cancel. You will remain with answer 2. So answer 2. Then the correct option is option C. Right. Now next sum. Choose the correct option again. Take down the question. Sec theta plus 10 theta in one bracket into 1 minus sin theta. Again, transform that sec and 10 in terms of sin and cos. So sec can be written as 1 upon cos A, and tan A can be written as sin A upon cos A into 1 minus sin A. This step, right? Now take the LCM in first bracket. So the denominators are same. So LCM is cos A, and the numerator is 1 plus sin A into second bracket as it is 1 minus sin A. Now 1 plus sin A into 1 minus sin A in the numerator, divided by cos A. Again use that identity A plus B A minus B. So by that identity it will become A square minus B square, that is 1 square minus sin square A, right? So and 1 square is 1 minus sin square A upon cos A, right? Then according to the identity, cos square theta is what? 1 minus sin square theta. See this identity here. So replace this 1 minus sin square A by cos square A. So cos square A upon cos A. So 1 cos will get cancelled and you will remain with cos A in the numerator. So the correct option is option D. Next, 1 plus tan square A upon 1 plus cot square A. So here also 1 plus tan square A, you convert sin square A upon cos square A, divided by 1 plus cot square A, you can write it as cos square A upon sin square A. Now you take the LCM in the numerator as well as denominator and balance the numerator. So in the numerator, LCM is cos square A, then cross multiply, you will get cos square A plus sin square A whole divided by the LCM in the denominator is sin square A, cross multiply sin square A plus cos square A upon sin square A. Now convert this division into multiplication and take the reciprocal of the denominator. So you will get cos square A plus sin square A upon cos square A. Division converted into multiplication and the reciprocal of the denominator, that is sin square A upon cos square A plus sin square A. But we have identity cos square A plus sin square A is 1. So here you replace cos square A plus sin square A by 1. So 1 upon cos square A into sin square A upon 1. So this will become sin square A upon cos square A. Sin upon cos is nothing but tan. So it is tan square A. So the correct option is option D, tan square A. Now next example. If A, B and C are interior angles of triangle ABC, then show that sine of angle B plus C by 2 is equal to cos of A upon 2, right? So since A, B and C are the interior angles of a triangle, we can apply angle sum property of a triangle. So according to that, angle A plus angle B plus angle C is 180 degree, right? Now children, in the required expression we want divided by 2, angle divided by 2. So for that, let us divide both the sides of this equation by 2. So here A plus B plus C divided by 2 and 180 divided by 2 is 90, right? Now here in the required answer we want B plus C upon 2. So what we will do, we will keep B plus C upon 2 on left hand side and you shift A by 2 on right hand side. So B plus C by 2 is equal to 90 and this A by 2 you shift on right hand side, so that will become minus A upon 2, right? Then we want sine ratio. So taking sine ratio on both the side, so sine of B plus C by 2 is equal to sine of 90 minus A by 2. Children, do you remember the complementary angles, trigonometric ratios of complementary angle? Sine 90 minus theta is cos theta. So same way here also, sine 90 minus A by 2 is cos A by 2. So in this way, we have proved sine of B plus C by 2 is equal to cos of A by 2. Yes. Now next time, prove the following identities where the angles involved are acute angles for which the expressions are defined. This is the given expression. So in prove that type, you have to start with any one side and show that it is equal to the other side. So let us start with left hand side. So you copy the left hand side of the expression as it is. So LHS is square root of 1 plus sin A upon 1 minus sin A. So in this type of expressions, we need to rationalize the denominator. So for rationalizing, what we do? We multiply and divide the same expression by the conjugate of its denominator. So denominator is 1 minus sin A. So you multiply and divide by its conjugate, that is 1 plus signing. So here in this step we have multiplied and divided by 1 plus sin a, right? Now see numerator, square root of 1 plus sin a into 1 plus sin a is 1 plus sin a the whole square, and denominator is 1 minus sin a into 1 plus sin a. So it is in the form of identity, a minus b, a plus b, that is equal to a square minus b square. Right hand side it is given, so that will become 1 square minus sin square a. Now after this, denominator is 1 minus sin square a, and we have identity 1 minus sin square a is cos square a here. So replace that denominator by cos square a. So the square root of, come to this step, square root of 1 plus sin a upon cos a the whole square. Okay, and children, square and square root, they cancel each other. So you will get 1 plus sin a upon cos a. Now you distribute this denominator over the numerator. So separate it, you will get 1 upon cos a plus sin a upon cos a. So 1 upon cos a is sec a plus sin a upon cos a is tan a, and that is our required right hand side. So in this way we can prove LHS is equal to RHS. Now next example, again prove this sin theta minus 2 sin cube theta upon 2 cos cube theta minus cos theta is equal to tan theta. So that left hand side expression you copy down, right? Now see the numerator. From the numerator, what is common? Sin theta is common. So you take that sin theta outside the bracket. So what will come inside the bracket? 1 minus 2 sin square theta. Now from the denominator also, cos theta is common. So inside the bracket, 2 cos square theta minus 1, right? Okay. Sin theta upon cos theta, you write into bracket 1 minus 2 sin square theta upon 2 cos square theta minus 1. Okay, now children, sin theta upon cos theta is what? Tan theta. So let us write that ratio as tan theta into 1 minus 2 sin square theta upon 2 cos square theta minus 1. Now in next step, you replace this cos square theta by 1 minus sin square theta. We have this identity, cos square theta plus sin square theta is 1, and when you shift sin square theta on right hand side, you will get cos square theta as 1 minus sin square theta. So let us replace this cos square theta by 1 minus sin square theta here, right? So now you replace this cos square theta by 1 minus sin square theta, and next step, in the denominator you multiply that 2 inside the bracket. So you will get tan theta into 1 minus 2 sin square theta in the numerator divided by 2 minus 2 sin square theta minus 1, right? Now in the denominator, plus 2 minus 1 will become 1. So the next is tan theta into 1 minus 2 sin square theta upon 1 minus 2 sin square theta. So this 1 minus 2 sin square theta, this they will get cancelled. So the answer is tan theta, which is our right hand side, right? Now next example, prove that sec a into 1 minus sin a into sec a plus tan a is equal to 1. So you copy down left hand side, right? Then you convert this sec A in as 1 upon cos A into 1 minus sin A as it is. Now in third bracket, sec A, this sec A you can write as 1 upon cos A plus tan A you can write as sin A upon cos A, right? Now in third bracket the LCM is cos A, right? Denominators are same. So when you simplify this, so in denominator you will get cos A into cos A, that is cos square A, and numerator this 1 minus sin A and here 1 plus sin A. So 1 minus sin A into 1 plus sin A divided by cos square A. So this 1 minus sin A into 1 plus sin A, according to identity, this is 1 minus sin square A upon cos square A. And 1 minus sin square A is cos square A. So cos square A upon cos square A is 1, and that is our right hand side. Right. Now, next example. Again, take left hand side, copy down that left hand side expression, cos A upon 1 plus sin A plus 1 plus sin A upon cos A. Take the LCM. LCM is 1 plus sin A into cos A. Now balance the numerator, or you can cross multiply. So cos A into cos A plus 1 plus sin A into 1 plus sin A. So cos A into cos A is cos square A plus 1 plus sin A the whole square divided by 1 plus sin A into cos A, right? Now cos square A plus, now this 1 plus sin A the whole square, this you can expand by using A plus B the whole square formula. So cos square A plus 1 square plus sin square plus 2 sin A divided by 1 plus sin A into cos A, right? So now cos square A plus sin square A you take together, plus 1 square is 1 plus 2 sin A and divided by that denominator as it is. So here in previous step, cos square A plus sin square A is 1 plus 2 sin A divided by the denominator as it is, 1 plus sin A into cos A. So 1 plus 1 is 2 plus 2 sin A upon 1 plus sin A into cos A. So from the numerator you take out 2 common. So 1 plus sin A divided by 1 plus sin A into cos A. So that bracket 1 plus sin A and 1 plus sin A will get cancelled. These two brackets will get cancelled. So now what is remaining? 2 upon cos A. So that can be written in this form. 2 into 1 upon cos A. And 1 upon cos A is sec A. So you will get that is equal to 2 sec A. That is the required right hand side. Okay, understood. Now let us take next example. So children, every time it is not possible to take any one side and solve till end to get the right hand side. Sometimes what we have to do, we have to solve both the sides partially and get the equal answer. Okay, so here it is. So here left hand side I have solved partially, and right hand side few steps I have done, so that after some particular steps you will get both the sides equal. So you copy down left hand side first. Left hand side is 1 plus sec A upon sec A, right? So now you distribute that denominator over the numerator or separate it. So you will get 1 upon sec A plus sec A upon sec A, right? So 1 upon sec A is cos A and sec a upon sec a 1. So cos a plus 1. Let us stop here. Now copy down the right hand side column. Sin square a upon 1 minus cos a. Right. Now according to the identity, sin square a is nothing but 1 minus cos square a. Right hand side in the box, reason is given. So that numerator sin square a I have replaced by 1 minus cos square a divided by 1 minus cos a. Right. So that can be written as 1 square minus cos square a and 1 minus cos a as it is in the denominator. So using that identity, a square minus b square is equal to a minus b into a plus b, you expand the numerator. You will get 1 minus cos a into 1 plus cos a divided by 1 minus cos a. So what will happen? This 1 minus cos a, 1 minus cos a will get cancelled and you will remain with 1 plus cos a. So in this way, LHS and RHS are same. Okay, so we can solve partially both the side and try to get the equal answer. So children, I hope you have understood the sums which we have discussed today. Okay, and in the textbook, some more examples are there. Try to solve them. Okay, we'll see in the next lecture.